There's just too much wheels.
Oh God, where do we start?
I know we said it before. We said it in our January video that that was probably the biggest collection of used JDM wheels, like mixed JDM wheels. I know there's three pieces, and there's other places in the US that have a big stock of three-piece wheels, either between stuff they're building for customers or their own personal stock. But I would say that this is the largest collection of used mixed Japanese wheels outside of Japan, unless someone in Japan is hoarding like a mega collection. But I don't know, I really can't think of anywhere that has this much stuff.
I don't think there is.
Like, I think we actually have right now the largest collection of used Japanese wheels in the world, which is kind of nuts. Oh yes, boy, I always like these in white, especially with a deep face like that. They've got the glow-in-the-dark sticker, which you've seen us do many times. But yeah, they look beautiful in white. They just remind me of just drift cars from like 2005 and stuff.
Diamond encrusted as well, eh?
Oh my God, look at this!
The Yazoo.
Oh man. Can you see that, Jay? The center is broken, but you know what makes up for it? There's the diamond encrusted custom finish that's on there. That is absolutely the funniest thing ever. Leon Hardart. Advan RZDFs with a custom fake
carbon centers.
They're like 80s touring car wheel. It's been redesigned for modern day. Look at that face, man.
They are fucking great.
Yes, Crimson RSDP cups. So obviously the cup name is inspired by, I don't know, Euro German stuff from the 80s. And you know what's more mental than all that? How the tire is fitted. Look at that.
Man, look at that.
So that's full pressure on that. I feel bad for Adrian having to take that off. So these are obviously redesigned then for like the stance movement that's going on in Japan, which is going on all around the world, mostly in the US and definitely in Japan, who seem to lead that movement. But the thing is to try and stretch the most mental tire possible onto a wheel and kind of brag about it then. And as you can see here, this tire is somehow sealed and after catching a bead, but it's not even on the lip. Look at that. There's like a good inch in there. And it's actually fully inflated.
They'd be fun anyway to take off.
How insane is that? What size are they? 17s. They just look angry. Jeez. Most angry looking mesh wheel to ever come out of Japan.
Logo's great as well.
Yeah, the Rezax looked like it was carved in anger. Rezax! Like, it looks like someone carved it with fucking blood or something. If a metal band was a wheel, this is,
some logo.
It's a black metal band as a wheel. Even this fucking everything is just like the album cover of a black metal band. MS1s. We actually are forgetting a heap of MS1s. Which is, yeah, cool. I am a sucker for a Mark II. Oh man, they're gorgeous. Sean's favourite. Oh, look at these. What's going on there?
Are they gone wrong or are they?
It's like it's gone wrong, but it's gone wrong in all the right ways. It's like a hologram. Come over here and see if there's like...
Yeah, you can.
That is mental. Hi. What are these? Amazing. More RS. This is more Advans.
Oh, cool.
We are taking all the Advans out of Japan. There's a set of emotions down there. Cool Vers.
How cool are these?
Work Vers. They are brand new as well. Never been mounted. Immaculate. Don't even have valves in them. A valve course. Look at that. It's a brand new wheel. Another C28s.
Oh, no way.
Really, really nice sizes for the GTC. And just all the top secret drift cars with the S15 and that. And then they had them on the Skyline 350 GT that they did as well. Just top secret basically owned the wheel. They should have just kept making them, putting it on all the newer top secret cars as well. But
they don't still make them, do they?
Nah. Ready for a smoky black equip?
A bit of smoky black.
Them.
They are great.
Man, they're like new. Must be a custom job smoky black finish on.
Center caps are great.
Yeah, they're literally brand new. They look like they were mounted once. The center cap is lovely, it's super nostalgic. Look how clean they are. So, work equip 40s. The 40 was a 40th anniversary wheel that they did for work. They brought it out in 2000 and 19, I think. Gnosis.
BMW.
Which look like a real BMW wheel, because they almost look like standard M5 wheels. I think they come on the E39.
I think the 7 series from the late 90s came with wheels like that
and
as well.
Just basically a kind of a probably a blatant rip-off of it. Here's some Mazda Speed MSO1s, maybe.
Oh, cool.
Excellent wheel. Minus the centre cap, unfortunately. Oh my god. This is, yeah, no, same again. They're mint.
Yeah, aren't they?
Look at them. 18
fuck
by 9.5 plus 12.
Brand new tyres as well.
Brand new tyres. Everything's
just
brand
fitted.
New. Look, I know people are probably sick of seeing T37s in the videos, but
we're not.
When you work somewhere and you look at wheels all the time, like, and we look at a lot of wheels all the time, it just never gets old. It's like finding a piece of gold or something. I know they are finished in the bronze, but it just, there's something about the T37. This is starting to flake the same way that we saw the Minervas down there, and it looks like a disco ball. But these look like, but I could be wrong, they look like Garrison Deep Racings without the centre cap. Very, very, very cool wheel from back in the day. Some of the BN demo cars used to have them on, like the S13s and that. What an awesome wheel. I haven't seen them in years. They were kind of popular years ago and then they kind of vanished. VS KFs. Alloy wheels by four and then it just goes
pound divided pound by pound A pound A pound A pound O pound O pound A pound pound 90s.
We're saying 90s, sorry, yeah. Oh, boom. Ta-da.
They're big as well.
So you're putting little hashtags on everything that's sold.
Yeah, just so you know.
Oh yeah, oh,
they're cool.
They look like 16s. So there's a BMW fitment Koenigs. Well, you can't see it from the face because it just looks the exact same as all of them, but tap tap. BCNR 33 wheels. As we say every single time, probably the best.
Oh, they are the best
OEM wheel of all time. These are, look like brand new T37s. Okay, absolutely the polar opposite of what I thought they were. They're actually BMW fitment RSO 5RRs. Well, like, I've given up, but there's Equipo ones in there. It's like a cola lolly orange. Look at that. It's like a, almost like a pearlescent candy orange. Let's see if you lick it, it'll fizz your tongue.
Lick it.
No, that's just dirt. Agile Struss with a lot of chrome flake. Hello, purple one. Oh my god, they're absolutely gorgeous. Very nice sizes. They are a nice wheel and a nice size. They're definitely one of my favourite wheels. Growing up as an 86 enthusiast in Ireland, D-Mac down in Cork used to just bring in a lot of these wheels. And a lot of them came in from Japan, so like most of the 86s in Cork and down in the southeast had equips on them back in the day. I like the centre cast, but they just look nicer on a shelf than on the wheel. Oh, these are definitely, I can tell you just from here that they're Enki NTO3s. And judging by the datum, they could be Enki NTO3 RRs, which are the newer version of it. Because there's only one wheel that has that mad outer strip on it like that. And it is Enki NTO3 RR, which is exactly what it is. That's when you start getting real creepy, when you know a wheel from the back. I don't know whether to be impressed with myself or kind of just creeped out, to be honest. So they brought out the T7R and then made a two-piece where they just give you the T7 face. Shiny chrome lip, because that's what people want. Give the perception of like a three-piece expensive wheel, but like they're not like $4,000. I think they're like, you know, maybe $2,000 for a set. And then used, they're actually relatively not cheap but affordable. And the cool perception as well of the 2P is the spokes, they get really far and then they go back with the design, so it makes them look like they have a deeper lip on them, so they look dishy. I'm getting a lot of these. Like you said in one of our recent videos, they were a heavily copied wheel back in the day in Ireland. You'd see them on absolutely everything, like in 14s and 15s. We actually see an old guy driving around here in a Micro with a set of like Fox or Dare version of these wheels. But yeah, there's the original design. It's the AVS Model 5 twin spoke design. Nice. They look a bit mad without the centre cab. Minervas.
Yeah.
Cool. Still have the centre cabs, which is actually a bonus for whoever bought them. No way. Rays.
Are they the ghoul cars?
Ghoul cars.
No way.
I don't know why Dave bought these, but I'm happy he did. These are so cool. Look at them. I'm so happy to see a set of these. I'm not sure why, like, inanimate fucking objects give me joy, but these give me a lot of joy. So, these are work goo cars, and I didn't know they came in these kind of chunkier sizes, but they're supposed to be like a nostalgic throwback to like a 1960s and 70s hot rod era wheel, and they just, you can see with that design, they look like a Prager or a fucking old American kind of drag wheel, but something that you can just fit onto a modern day car. And they did make them in a couple of sizes that fit onto other cars, but you never really see them around. You only ever see them on like K cars that try to look like American stuff, you know. But these are proper big sizes of them. They look like they could be like 9.5s or 9s.
Are they rolls or things? Are they just solid? Hello.
Peeping into the Advan. Not included with the wheels, unfortunately.
There is now.
Super Advan. What are they called? Gramlide 57DRs or something like that. I need to brush up on my Gramlites. This is our mesh. In. They look like 15s. No, they're 15s. Just threw me off. Aren't they cool? Wow. SSR MS3s. Pretty cool. They are very, very nice. Some of the newer, more affordable wheels from Gramlite.
Some colour on, isn't it?
Yeah, it's like
it sounds like fucking blue
satin,
grey.
Yeah. And it's a satin kind of colour as well. More Longchamps.
Holy finish shit. On it.
Look how deep that is. Man, every single wheel design looks better with a big, massive lip on it.
The way they cut into it there.
Yeah. I've never seen a set that big. I didn't even know they came in that size. Usually see them in much shallower offsets. Oh, more you have a king. They're like the three-piece version of them. 3-piece 6-car. Yabba King. I think they're Yabba Kings now. Don't hate on me if I get it wrong. I'm not up on the much of the newer 326 power stuff, but there you go. Very nice. A bit of corrosion. They need a bit of love. Fuck. There you go. The absolute holy grail size in them as well. Probably 17 by 9 or 10s. And they come with the original centers with the little coin in them as well, which is super cool. Original stickers. Totally unrestored. Look at that, an original Japanese bug. Look, look at him. A little creepy Japanese bug. It's not great for us, is it? In our ecosystem. RGs, how cool are they?
They are incredible. Them, sadly, they're sold.
Sold.
Wow, look at these.
Let's say 55Ms.
We had these in January. Yeah, exact did, same yeah. colour, yeah.
Same colour with the inked side on them. Really made a bad. Chopping up that up garage bag. Nice, we won't bother fully opening them because we know what they are for wet sports. Wet sports are another. They don't really seem to get the love outside of Japan. SA55Ms. This is definitely the best colour they came in. The candy blue is nice.
There's some concave on them. Yeah. Shit.
But the satin gunmetal with the machine side is just unbelievable. Look at the size of them. Man. What are they, like 10 G's, 10 and a half?
They are fucking huge.
What fucking size are these? 18 by 10s.
They definitely went fast.
Oh man.
Very
I
fast.
I only had one purpose in life and that was to go fast. What size is my shoe? Shoe's a size 9. Yeah, shoes.
I'm a size 7.
7.
Not even the same width as the tire.
There you go for a comparison. They're actually Meisters. Very nice little twin cam sizes. This container has it all.
Wow.
And not only are they Regamasters, but they're the Regamaster Marquise Promoter in a monstrous rare size. So they look like Oh Jesus, these are literally the holy grail size as well. 17 by 10. Yeah, 17 by 10. Plus fucking, what does it say? It's all worn away. But if I was to guess, say, look at the size of them. 17 by 10. Probably plus 22 or plus 15 or something. So we've said it before and stuff, but the Marquis promoted versions have the centre cap fused into them. And then the Regamaster Evos, which were more intended for racing, even though it's just kind of the same wheel with the centre cap chopped out of it, is the Evo version. So they're kind of just the same wheel, really. Obviously not to everyone's personal taste, but on the grand scheme of like what people would love to see and like what people would love to own, we have every single thing here.
Sitting here Blix, somewhere.
Blix Type 03s, like Regamasters,
Minervas,
Longchamps, Nismo LM GT1s, Nismo LM GT2s, T37s, Holy Grail sizes, fucking C28s, P1s, like Advan RGs, like it's fucking unbelievable what's here. Like, everything you would ever want to see if you walked into an up garage or anywhere in the world into like to look at used wheels is here right now, like everything, which is fucking nuts. We're not even, we're only halfway, I think.